Hello again everybody and a very warm welcome back to the channel. Today we have an additional ATR tutorial in our ATR tutorial series for Microsoft Flight Simulator, and we're going to be discussing some of the changes that have affected the aircraft post AAU2. Just before that, the ATR received a really big update improving a number of features and tweaking some of the ways that the aircraft work, and one of those is the way that the hydraulic systems are simulated and the way that hotel mode and the prop brake works. So I'm going to show you the changes in this video today. Hit like and subscribe and share your thoughts in the comments below. And if you've not checked out my ATR tutorial series yet, then check out the playlists on the channel. So we begin our journey here at Inverness. And as we enter the flight deck, we've gone through a number of our pre-flight preparations and checks for the aircraft, but we're on ground power at the moment. If you're not sure how to do a lot of the stuff shown in this video, then check out the other tutorials, episodes 1 and beyond up to this episode, and it will help you get up to speed with all of the bits like creating your flight plan and working out your performance for takeoff and all that sort of thing. We're focusing purely on the key changes to the hydraulic systems today, and with that we need to talk about this button here, ground control only hydraulic auxiliary pump, and it's just below the part brake to the left of the two throttle levers here. Now, if we look in the overhead panel, we've done some of the pre-flight bits up here. So we've got nav lights on, for example. We're going to pop the wing lights on as well because we are going to activate the aircraft's hotel mode. And you'll notice this time around, prop brake is off, but there is no ready illumination. If we pop pump 2 onto run and move the starter to A and B, we can move this. And it will show blue, but we might get some issues. So we're going to turn on the hydraulic power. We're going to look down, and all of a sudden now as well, we've got prop brake showing ready. We're going to press the hydraulic auxiliary pump. We're going to then look back up to the prop brake, open the guard and turn it on. And now you can see it says ready prop brake in green and blue. And we're going to start engine 2 in hotel mode. Now what we need to do is move the engine into feather mode only, and engine 2 will start in hotel mode with the prop brake engaged. And this is all about as well turning the prop brake off when we're ready to start the engines. So as you can see, the prop brake is enabled. It's displayed there on the engine display in the center screen, and we've got ITT risen and shown green at the moment, and we're also using a little bit of fuel in the tanks too now because we've got an engine on. Prop brake's working quite nicely, and we're going to continue with all of our pre-flight checks, get everything ready to go, and then we're going to push back and release the prop brake. Right, so what we've done now is we've pushed back from the stand, but we've left the engine running in hotel mode just so that I can demonstrate the steps without having the aeroplane actually in motion and having to monitor all of that as well. So post update, this is now how you release the ATR prop brake, and it's going to focus on that hydraulic auxiliary pump button there and the condition lever, which is currently in the feathered position FTR. We're going to look up and we can see that we've got all of our hydraulic pumps on. The auxiliary blue and green pumps are all on. Auxiliary pump has no warnings, but we've got blue and green showing low pressure. We're going to have engine start mode switches to whichever is applicable, start A, B or A and B. And you can see prop brake is shown on at the moment and blue. We don't have the ready illuminated light there. So what we need to do is head down here and just do a very quick click on hydraulic auxiliary pump, and then we're going to look straight back up. Straight back up, prop brake ready, green, release the guard. Turn the part brake, the prop brake off. Now we get unlock in red, condition lever, automatic, released. Then we're going to continue with the same engine start that we normally would for engine one as we get to the hold. But that's how you start the engines now, having engaged hotel mode with engine two in the ATR for Microsoft Flight Simulator. Hope you're enjoying it. Hope you've really enjoyed the tutorial series as well. I know lots of you have. Really good to see. Hit like and subscribe and come check out Osprey Airways, our virtual airline, via New Sky. Thanks for watching. I'll see you soon. Take care.